Ghostbusters 2016. You can't talk about this movie without discussing the build-up to it. When they announced it would be a remake and all-female team, the internet lost its mind. Those who were angry felt as if Hollywood was personally attacking their childhood. Others didn't like the idea of a female-driven story. And some just loved the original cast and film so much that they didn't want to see it touched at all by any other creative type. Things on social media became just plain nasty as stars of the movie and the director himself were attacked on Twitter in some of the most mean-spirited, that's pun intended, ways. Those involved with the relaunch of the franchise fought back, and now here we are. Ghostbusters is trying to become a thing again. Is it any good? Should you see it? Well, let's get started. I honestly can't believe that a film so innocent has been such a lightning rod for controversy. I mean, just look at the trailer. It's the most voted down in the history of YouTube. And to be fair, that trailer was absolute garbage. The film, however, is clearly better than the busted trailer, even though many of the jokes from that trailer you see coming a mile away during the movie. I would have liked to have seen some alternate or unused comedic material featured in the actual film, instead of the same three or four jokes you've already seen a number of times in all the promotional material. However, with all that being said, this movie is not awful, but I will never see it again. I don't care what the circumstances are. If my 12-year-old niece wants to see it, too bad, it's not happening. There's just too much quality content to watch this thing again. I mean, the original Ghostbusters had a tremendous amount of rewatchability. This one is mostly forgettable. A lot of the highlights from this film are from the numerous amount of cameos and tie-ins to the original. And while they're all mostly done well, I look forward to seeing a day where this new franchise can somewhat stand on its own. See, I'm one of the people who thinks Melissa McCarthy, Kristen Wiig, Leslie Jones, Kate McKinnon, and the rest of the SNL alum that are in this movie are not only some of the funniest women on the planet, but also the funniest people. I'm all for the casting and the directorial position being given to the greatest comedy director of the past decade, Paul Feig. He's done comedies like Bridesmaids, The Heat, Spy, and he has a great system down and didn't come across as overwhelmed by this task of bringing one of the most beloved comedy franchises back from the dead. But once again, as I've been saying, this movie is something I'll never watch again. It's passable. It's one in which you'll be able to chuckle your way through. It's not very hard-hitting. It doesn't really stay with you, but it's a vehicle to help reestablish a brand. One in which I'm sure Columbia Pictures hopes becomes a hit series of films. Unlike the original, this movie doesn't really inspire you to want to be a Ghostbuster. Maybe a young girl sees this movie and has that enthusiasm that most young children did back in the country in the 80s, but I don't think there will be enough kids out there that care about this relaunch, mainly because much of the movie's emotional impact is based upon scenes drumming up sentiment from the original. The biggest problem with this movie is the fact that every 20 minutes the dialogue turns into a bunch of scientific gobbledygook, so we'll buy into the fact that these characters know what they're doing. So we have to sit through discussions with a bunch of made-up scientific terms, and that gets annoying. Also, there's one odd moment in which a joke is made about terrorism, and it also feels out of place and uncalled for given the times in which we live. I didn't feel as if it was handled in a very sensitive manner, especially towards those who may have been affected personally. The best two things about the movie are its running inside jokes and its end credits. I know that sounds like an insult, but stick around for the end. It's like a huge party celebrating the last 2 hours, and it's infectiously fun. I wish the rest of the movie had been that energetic and engaging. The ghosts look fine, but the humor and action scenes involving them seem less Ghostbusters and more Scooby-Doo. They even say, "Let's split up," and I've lost my glasses. They approach the ghosts in the same way those driving the mystery machine would. All they were missing was a talking dog. In summary, this movie's not worth all the hate. It's not disrespectful to the original, it has some funny lines, and the chemistry's there. If you appreciate SNL, the success of this movie is fueled by those talents. Overall, it's a small film for the first two acts. It really saves its summer blockbuster status for the third act, where chaos ensues and the budget is spent. Chris Hemsworth is a smart addition, even though much of the humor surrounding his one-note characters hit or miss. He brings a certain charm to the story. Look, this is a silly movie about two scientists, a pyromaniac, and a working-class New York City amateur historian. I probably spent too much time on it already. It shouldn't be taken too seriously as something that advances women's rights. These ladies have already proven themselves to be some of the most talented entertainers in the world, Seeing this movie really shouldn't change the way you thought before seeing it, whether you felt positive or negative about the franchise reboot. I give this film a C+. And while I won't be seeing this again, I'll catch the next Ghostbusters, if there is one. I know Ray Parker Jr. wouldn't mind the paycheck. Until next time, enjoy your trip at the movies. I'm Tim Melton.